Our early careers team recently won the Diversity and Inclusion Strategy Award, which we're really proud of. In terms of why I think we won that award, the approach that we've taken to our attraction strategy has really been about working with a large number of different groups, organisations, to really engage with a wide number of students from different backgrounds, from different areas of the country, and really try to kind of work with those students to support them through the application process. In terms of our strategy, we work with those organisations to do a number of different activities. So some of them might be broader, kind of sharing job roles and sharing what we do and sharing opportunities. But then also we do more bespoke events where we target certain groups to really support them. And they might be groups who may struggle to have access to some of the opportunities that we have. And we work with those students to really help build their confidence, build their knowledge of Aon, understand our business, and really help them through the recruitment process. So, you know, when they come to an assessment centre, they feel confident that they can share all of the skills and experiences that they've had and hopefully be successful in an assessment centre. We also focus very heavily on doing activities that will really have that return on investment, so we can really see the impact from when we get students attending at an event all the way through the recruitment process to the outcome, whether they're offered or if they're unsuccessful, understanding why. So using the data that we gather through Aon Assessment Solutions and all of the assessment processes, we're able to see kind of where we have areas where students are not as successful, but also where the investment that we've put into those activities has really paid off. Our recruitment process starts with an online application, so students can access this application through our early careers website. When they submit an application, it's really straightforward. We don't ask for loads of information at this point, so it's really just to upload their CV, their personal information, but also we ask them to share with us if they require any reasonable adjustments throughout the process. And we ask for this information at the early stage so that we're able to make sure that that is included in the entire process and they're able to have those adjustments built in throughout all of the activities that they do. Once they've met that initial screening stage, they're then invited to complete some online tests. Those situational judgment tests, where we give them a range of scenarios to look at and provide their answers to those, and also the numerical reasoning test, so we get to see their numerical understanding as well. Once they've completed that, they then take part in a video interview, so they are presented with a series of questions. The questions they can review, they can kind of practice their answers and make sure that they're ready before they go in front of their camera, and then they record their answers. And at all of those stages, they're screened, and if they're successful, they move through to the next stage. And then the final stage is the assessment centre. And currently, Aon run all of our assessment centres virtually, and these are days where candidates will join us on a WebEx, and they have the opportunity to take part in group activities, presentations, interviews, and there's also a written task that we do as well. And if they're successful, they'll get a call from someone from the early careers team to provide them with the good news that they've been offered the job. But we also provide feedback to candidates at all stages of the process, which I know is so valuable to candidates. Irrespective of the outcome, it's so helpful to get that feedback, and all of that feedback comes through the information that's gathered throughout each of the different stages, and that's provided by Aon Assessment Solutions. It's important that our early careers recruits are looked after once they've had the offer, because often when they are given that offer, it's a long time before they actually join us. So we do a number of different activities. We send them a goodie bag with a hoodie that they can wear around campus or school. They also are invited to a welcome event where they get to meet more of the other colleagues that will be joining at the same time as them, as well as their team. So we really try and work with them over that time so that they feel excited about joining Aon. Once our early career folks join, they take part in an induction. So we have all of them all together for a couple of weeks usually, and it's a really good opportunity for them to build their network and feel excited and energised about joining Aon. We spend some time with them talking about the Aon story, talking about our values, and sharing with them kind of the really core elements of our business. And then we do some softer sales training, some networking, they meet senior leaders, people from their team, and it's a really fun way to start working for us. They then start learning the technical element of their role. So they're split into smaller groups, and they'll start their technical training to really get them up to speed before they join the business. Once they're in the business, there's a really excellent development plan that our graduates, interns and apprentices will take part in, which is built around making sure that they are brought back together to have sort of centralised learning, where they do lots of different activities together, including projects that are focused around Aon United and bringing all of our colleagues together. And then there's an element of self-directed learning. So this is where they can really drive their own learning and go down areas where they want to learn more or areas of interest, and they can really explore those through all of the resources that we have available. All of our early career folks are also assigned a buddy, someone who they can go to and ask lots of questions. And we also have something called Mentor Loop here at Aon, which is a great way for colleagues to really engage with another member of the organisation who's perhaps a bit more experienced, to provide that mentor support as well, to really support with the retention and engagement that we need to have for our early career talent. Early career recruits are looking for those career paths. They're looking to see what's next. They're not just looking for a standalone job. They want to have progression. So for us, it's really important from a retention perspective to make sure that, you know, we've got these incredible, talented young people. We want them to stay in our organisation. But also from an engagement perspective, it's so important that they have opportunities, not just within one path, but they're able to see lots of different opportunities across different areas of our business. We're such a large organisation that those paths are not set in stone. There are lots of different opportunities. So it's really important that we present those to our early career folks, and they're able to explore those opportunities when the time comes.